And the push for green is not only affecting what we eat and drink, but also what we wear. So-called green fashion was once a small niche in the global marketplace, but now it's grown into a multi-billion dollar industry. CCTV's Karina Huber reports.
New York designer Tiziana Inglis is in the process of putting together her next collection. Isa Rodriguez, a color expert, goes through a selection of dyes Tiziana will use for her fabrics. All of the dyes are natural and have been extracted from plants.
We have logwood that is from the heartwood of a tree, the logwood tree.
Tiziana paints the dyes on swatches of fabric she will use in her spring 2014 collection.
I've gotten pegged quite a bit as a sustainable designer. I buy organic cottons from Japan, veg tanned leathers from France and Italy.
But all of her clothes are locally made in New York, and this has made her very popular among the socially conscious set.
Green fashion is an umbrella term that means many things. It can refer to garments that use sustainable fabrics. It can also refer to the manufacturing process, one that supports fair trade practices and a low carbon footprint. While the definitions vary, one thing is clear: green fashion is becoming increasingly popular.
Green apparel and accessories are a $5 billion annual business in the U.S. While that only accounts for roughly 2% of the overall U.S. fashion market, it is far larger than a decade ago, when sales of green fashion were less than $500 million. Fashion experts say events like the collapse of the Bangladeshi garment factory last April that killed more than 800 factory workers has made many U.S. consumers think more deeply about how and where their clothing is made.
There is a hidden price tag to cheap garment production. It may not be in the final dollar sign that you're paying at the checkout, but it is in terms of people's livelihoods and people's well-being.
Brown says people are also more drawn to socially conscious clothing because they look better than in their early days when green clothing was synonymous with hemp and hippie culture. Large retailers like H&M, which has 2,500 stores around the world, are also jumping on the trend. The retailer has a new collection that uses recycled fabric, and a majority of their stores now accept used clothing, which can either be donated to charity or recycled. Brown says other retailers are going to have to come up with similar plans to lower their impact as global consumption continues to rise, putting greater pressure on the environment. Karina Huber, CCTV, New York.